This is the fourth video in this video series all about Beaver Themer and how you can use it to build better websites and build smarter websites without touching a line of code. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies, and I put these videos out almost daily. So if you like the content in the video, I'd hope you'd consider on clicking on that subscribe button, and there's a cute little bell next to it if you want notifications when I add new videos. You can go ahead and click on that and turn on the notifications, and YouTube will notify you. So this video is going to be about custom post types, and this is a concept that, whether you know it or not, you're actually dealing with custom post types if you've used WordPress for any amount of time. Now, this is the fourth video in this video series. The first one, I talked about creating custom layouts. The second video, I talked about creating custom headers and footers, and also something called a concept called theme parts. In the fourth video, I talked about creating custom fields and also showed you a demonstration of me using the plugin Advanced Custom Fields, and we're all leading up to right here about custom post types. So what a custom post type is any content that doesn't necessarily fit inside of a blog post. And this is lots of different types of content. If you're an e-commerce person and you're using WooCommerce and you have a product page, that's a custom post type. It doesn't fit in a blog post. If you have a website that has a maybe like a portfolio option there, and you can add portfolio options, that is a custom post type. Or a team or staff directory, another custom post type. Now, there's a reason why probably you might not have ever created a custom post type before, because number one, the post type, while it's easy to create, it's very hard to style this custom post type. Now, this is the pre-Beaver Themer days. It was all custom code. So yes, you could go and create this custom post type, but then if you actually wanted to look good on the front end, good luck. I mean, unless you're a guy that's going to sit there and pound out the code and style that up with hard-coded and all that kind of stuff, it's just not something you probably even consider doing. But now that you have the option of Beaver Themer in your web development toolkit, now creating a custom post type might be a great solution to some of the different projects that you're taking on, or maybe some of the things that you want to do or add to your website. And so, like I said earlier, you're already using WooCommerce, you're using custom post types. If you're using LearnDash, which is a learning management system, and it has courses and it gets linked up with lessons and there's quizzes, those are all custom post types. If you're using any of the events plugins, where you go and you create a new event and you put the dates and the times and all that kind of stuff, newsflash, that is also a custom post type. And the good news is you can make your own custom post types, and it's really not rocket science. There are tools to allow you to do this. There's a whole bunch of tools, but I think what's going to be the best tool is called Pods. And right now, Pods does not have the integration complete with Beaver Themer. It's going to be coming out in just a matter of days. So in this video, I'm not going to really get deep into creating a custom post type with Pods. Well, I mean, I'll install it and we'll take a quick look at it, but I'm going to tell you, I'm going to be completely transparent with you. I've never created a custom post type. Why? Because if you look at number two in this little presentation, easy to create, it's hard to style, and I'm not sitting there popping out a design. I'm not doing that. I rather use a front-end page builder that makes it easy, and the only front-end page builder that will make it easy, will make the possibility of creating a beautiful custom post type, is Beaver Themer. And it's going to be using the Beaver Builder plugin that you already know how to use. So there is my confession. Here is Pod's website right here. It's a free plugin and it's been around a long time. Now, there are some things I don't like about it. Number one, I don't like that they don't have their own independent business model where they're actually selling it. It's completely free. I mean, isn't that crazy when they're giving it away for free, and you see that as a negative. Anyways, but if you scroll all the way down on their website, you could see they're being sponsored and supported by Automattic, Optin Monster, Gravity Forms. I don't know how much money or how often they give them money, but it is being supported, which is good to know. And actually, one of the people involved in the product you're going to see in our Beaver Builder group. You might have seen one of his helpful responses to a question in the Beaver Builder group or other Facebook groups, and it's this guy right here, Bernard. And I've never spoken to him, but we were communicating over Facebook Messenger yesterday because I'm like, hey, I want to do something for pods. I want to make a video on pods and how this is going to link into Beaver Themer. And he is the one that told me that it is coming and to sit tight. This is going to be the best solution for and the easiest to use solution for creating custom post types and custom fields. By the way, in the last video where I showed you advanced custom fields, where a lot of that you can actually do with pods. So I could have created that custom field and placed it in my blog post with pods. So I think I touched on this in a prior video where if your website does not need custom post types, in that scenario, you'd want to go with advanced custom fields. If your website is going to have custom post types, you would just go with pods, and you can also use pods to create those custom fields for WooCommerce products or for blog posts, whatever you want. So anyways, I'm in my WordPress site here. I'm going to go to plugins, add new, and I've never done this before, so we're going to just do it here together. And it's a good example of you don't have to be afraid of breaking something. So let me search for it. All right, pods, just like that. And here it is, pods, custom content types and fields. I'm going to install that. And it looks like they have a bunch of add-ons here, which is good to extend its functionality. All right, it's installed. Let's go ahead and activate it. I think it's just going to add an option down here. And there it is, pods admin. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. And this is pretty much what I would expect. Right here, I can click create new to create a new custom post type. And then right here is extend existing. And this is where I would create those different custom fields. So this is some real power. Well, obviously you could do more than just that. So I'm actually not going to go deeper into creating a custom post type. Why? Because the integration isn't fully done yet. So in about a week's time, when the integration is ready and I've had a moment to play around with it, I am going to go ahead and create a custom post type, show you how to do it. It's actually not that hard. It'll just take you a few minutes. And you already know how to use Beaver Themer if you've been watching these videos in the series. That's not going to be hard either. You're going to really have the power to make a completely custom solution for yourself or for your web development clients, things that you wouldn't have been able to do before unless you were willing to dig in deep with custom code. You're going to be able to do all of that now. Now, I will say there's other plugins that will facilitate you creating a custom post type. And what I think I like about pods, though, is that you could do that, but you can also use it to extend existing post types that you have on your website. So you don't need to have another plugin and then also have advanced custom fields. But there's lots of different ways to skin a cat with WordPress. So what I'd like to do is ask you to, down below in the comment section, give me some ideas of great ways to use a custom post type, some maybe great use case scenarios for custom post types, so that we can kind of expand our way of looking at this, of what we can actually do with it. Also, if you've ever used pods, go ahead and leave your comments down below what you liked or did not like about pods. Now, what I'll do in the description, the video description, is once I have that pods video up, I will put a link there so that you don't have to go and search for it. But it's real easy to go to my channel and do a search, and I'll make sure the word pods is in the video title. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait for the next video. We are going to do a Q&A with Robbie, so make sure you're asking your questions. Once again, I'll have links to everything down below. Thank you for watching.